great to have a full house here. I'm really glad you guys came. I'm gonna pretend like
you're all here.
So maybe I should drink more first. Okay, so this has happened to all of us, I'm sure, in like one way or another. You know, you see somebody and you're like, that one. I want that one. I'm gonna have that one. I'm gonna do whatever I can possibly to have that one. Mine. Now, of course, like, this has happened to me a number of times in my life. But this time, I was really, really determined, okay? Now, I kind of had an obsession with this guy for quite a few years. I, like, worked with him and stuff, but, like, he got a girlfriend, and, you know, I've got all of these morals. And then he moved away, and I was a little sad about it, and, like, whatever, time passes. And then I found out he was coming into town to work an event. Simultaneously, my very best friend was coming into town also, and I was like, sweet, I've got my wingman. And so I get us tickets to the reserve room for the Art of Wine, okay? Now, this guy's like right up my alley, okay? He's like 6'5", he's got broad shoulders, big hands. He got a smile that'll drop anybody's panties, okay? So I learned early on also that, you know, you should dress for the job that you want. Not necessarily the job that you have, and as you can tell, I'm dressed to get my job back at Bernino's. Yeah. Reliving my youth, ladies and gentlemen. But I had planned this ensemble, okay? I had this beautiful, fiery red vintage slip that was just going to peek out just enough from this wrap dress in the highest heels that I could possibly maneuver around in. And I mean, I was looking good, okay? I knew what I wanted. I was a woman on a mission. So Draper and I get ourselves ready and we head to the Walton Arts Center and into the reserve room at the Art of Wine where that beautiful man was working the booth. And I'm in a beeline, okay? I was like, listen, I need to make my presence known, all right? So I show up and I'm kind of giving him the, hey, how are you? And he immediately, just like that, actually, I think. Picking up what I was putting down. I mean, like, I'm putting it down, okay? And I was like, dude, this is going to be so much easier than I thought it was going to be. Like, essentially, at this moment, I'm like, shit, my mission is accomplished. So I look at my girl, and I'm like, let's make a victory lap, or 3 to 5, here in the reserve room. And now she's a sommelier, okay? And that is a wine expert, in case you didn't know. And so we're there, and I'm like, just give me the good stuff, okay? I mean, I deserve it. I've already won. And she gives it to me, and there's a lot of it. So we're making our laps, you know, and I've probably consumed what feels like, or maybe was, somewhere near half a case of wine. And I'm feeling real good about myself, okay? And I'm like, oh, sweet, the event's over. Let's take the giant, and the three of us, we go across the street to, well, I mean, of course, have another drink. So we're sitting at the bar, hanging out for a minute, and he looks at me, and all of a sudden he goes, you know, there's something in my car I think you need to help me with. I'm like, oh my God, that's totally viable, right? Oh my God, yeah, sweet, let's go. And he's up, and he's out the door, and I am right behind him, okay? I'm like a drunken beast chasing that meat through a fucking parking lot. And he's like running, like legitimately running, so I'm legitimately chasing him. And of course, you know, I'm hammered, okay? And I miss the curb.
Oh, no.
And I'm in at least 5-inch wedges. Hit the curb, fall to the ground, ankle snaps. But before he can't even be worried about me because I'm up and I'm like, it's cool. I got the door down. Straighten myself out. And he opens the car door and I get in and he gets in and we like make out a little bit in the car because we're like, we're teenagers. It's great. And I realized all of a sudden, like, this is not going to do. Like, I'm not going to be able to accomplish the mission like this. I need more space. And then it occurs to me, you know, my salon is less than a mile from here. And we were off. And, you know, as you already can tell, I get lots of really amazing ideas when I'm drunk. And I had some brilliant ones in that moment. Anything that, like, any normal, sober human being would just, it wouldn't even occur to them, okay? But me, I'm like, wait a second. I've never given a blowjob in a Mercedes before. And so parked out behind my salon, I give a little idle roadhead. And I'm like, wait, we need to go inside. You cannot tame a beast in a coop. So I muster up all of my acting ability, bringing it all together. Because, you know, I'm the predator at this moment. I mean, in case that part got missed. And I don't want him to see any weakness, all right? And I'm going to guide him to the shop. And I am, like, hobbling, okay? At this point, like, hobbling. I mean, I guess probably that half case of wine eased the pain of it. So somehow, miraculously, I get us into the shop. I lock the door behind us. One of us removes my dress. And I take in this moment just for a second of consciousness where I realize all of my fantasies are about to come true. No longer will this all be in my imagination. This is going to be real live spank bang material. And I also realize that any normal human would probably be dead right now from alcohol poisoning. You know? But it's cool. I've totally got this. All right, so we head to the shampoo bowl. You know, I think I mentioned this guy was really tall, right? But the shampoo bowl is not working. Like, he is too tall. And so I'm like, all of a sudden, like, is that my phone ringing? And then I'm like, whatever, the counter. And I'm like, I'm too short for the counter. And the phone keeps ringing, right? And he's got a hold of my slip, okay? Like, this beautiful vintage slip has now become his fucking sex handle. He's like, got a hold of me, right? Because, like, I can't kind of stand. So you try the floor. It's concrete. That's a disaster. He takes me to the wall. Sex handle. I'm, like, wobbling around and everything. And I'm like, God, the phone. Oh, my God. Hold on a second. So I go over, and I get my phone. I'm like, hey. Oh, hey, girl, it's my friend. Oh, my God, you're at Buster's? Okay, yeah, it's cool. Where am I? It just doesn't matter. It's cool. No, I'm gonna be right there. Just hold on. Wait, don't move. You're Buster's? Okay, seriously. I got this. I'm gonna be right there. So I hang up, and I'm like, and we both have that moment where, you know, like, the battle is over, you know? And, I mean, he probably has that moment where he's like, legitimately, I'm, like, you know, past the point of any sort of, like, couth, or, like, he should be arrested at this point for trying to make a move on a girl that is in this situation. You know, so we somehow put my clothes back on, miraculously, and round everything up and get back out to the car. He's taking me to Buster's. And we're whizzing back that way. I'm like, wait a second, I should totally check my look in the mirror, okay? So, like, I pull down the visor, and I look in the mirror, and when the light shines on me, you guys, this is when the real challenge starts, okay? This is when the moment where I realize the rest of my night is totally fucked. Because I have a continental-sized hickey on the front of my head. And I mean, like, it's cute. Yeah, you're funny. Like, oh, shit, she got a hickey. Like, no, okay? Like, it's not on the side. It's not kind of small. It's not, like, maybe just pink. It's, like, black and purple, and it is right here. Okay? And, like, I got a little bit of hair at the time. But that's not gonna do it. I'm fucking hitting it. I'm like, how can you do this to me? You don't even know. He's a gym, okay? So there aren't any scarves in the car. All right, I have a little tiny handbag. There's no makeup in that thing, okay? I mean, like, my hair's long enough to, like, tie into the front like a bow. I'm just talking that funny. It's not working, you know? And I'm just like, here we go, right? So we get to Buster's. He has nothing to say for himself. And I'm like, that's cool, whatever. And I get out of the car with all of my grace that we established earlier. And I'm like heading into the bar and I bust open the door and I'm standing there for a second and I realize my dear friend isn't here. And then I realize, oh, look, there's a sweet little couple that I know and they're my clients. And they're like really sweet. They're like angelic even. Like they've probably never in their whole life seen something like the likes of me. I mean, they may have seen something like similar to it in a horror flick. Like there's like the girl, she got attacked by a werewolf, and now she's like dragging herself down an abandoned road, trying to like flag down a car, like they've seen shit like that, okay? But in real life, they haven't seen me, okay? I mean, picture it, okay? I'm like a 30-something-year-old woman. I'm dragging a leg behind me, okay? My clothes are probably askew. There's some sort of red something hanging out of there. Is that blood? What is it? We don't know, okay? And of course I've got the neck wound. Okay, because even in the dark that shit's obvious. And I'm like, hey, and I'm like, is salvation somewhere here? And then, no. And they like, I asked them actually, I'm gonna just go ahead and tell you that I fact checked a little bit on this because I was thinking maybe like somebody could like make me look better in this situation. But they couldn't. They were like, no, we didn't take you anywhere. I was like, did you at least like escort me out or anything? No, no. So in this moment, ladies and gentlemen, what was the predator is now the prey, and she hobbles out of that bar by herself, dragging her leg behind her. And now, I wish that I could tell you what happened exactly right then, next, and how I got to JR's. From Buster's. And I mean, I'm sure all of you are lucky enough to realize that that's all the way up Dixon Street, all the way up Block Street, all fucking uphill from there, you know what I'm saying? No, maybe somebody gave me a ride. I don't know. Like, no one's told me. Okay, you know. I mean, maybe I dragged my leg behind me. Maybe one of you here saw me. Maybe I'm an urban legend. There's just really no telling at this point. But I do remember the moment when I push open the door at JR's, and it's really raining. It's like last call light, you know? Like the ugly lights are on and shit, and we all know what I look like. Okay. There I go, dragging my leg and my leg. And everybody in slow motion, it feels like, turns to look. It was once this polished pearl. And they're like, oh, what is that? Who is it? Does she know she's not at the ER? And then as I'm looking through the crowd, as they're all having pity on me, my friend Aaron, like an angel of mercy, leaps up over all of the people in her booth and just like guides herself over to me, spins me on my one good leg and takes me towards the door, and she whispers, baby, we gotta get you out of here. And the next moment, well actually I guess it's not the next moment, but it's the next moment that I remember. I wake up. I open my eyes, daylight out, okay. It's my bedroom, okay. I'm alive, shit. Feels like death. Feels a lot like death right now. And then I'm like, oh my God, I gotta have the toilet like right now in some capacity. I'm not sure what, but like right now. So I like push the blanket back and I take one leap and I'm thinking maybe this leap is gonna take me straight to the bathroom. And it doesn't though. It takes me straight to the floor. And that moment I hear like these huge peals of laughter from above me, and I slowly take my hands and I push myself up and I look down at the tattered sex handle that I'm still sort of wearing. I feel the 100-pound stone that was once my foot, and I lock eyes with my girl Erin at the top of the bed, and she's just laughing and pointing at this huge wound on her neck and shaking her head like, ah. I just looked at her and I was like, I look like I got murdered! She was right. I mean, I was right. She agreed. I have not been drinking tonight, you guys. I don't know what you're talking about. But I just want you guys to know that because I got drunk, I may or may not be a local urban legend.